cyberbike duality that you had to submission and keep the original question.
Thank you for your introduction, and I'd like to thank the organizers for giving me the opportunity to speak here. Today, I'm going to talk about the relation between three dimensional cyberbike duality and Kajihara transformation, or old Kajihara transformation, or hyperdimensionalities, and K theoretical eye function. And this talk is based on a work which will appear in archive. Since I'm a physicist, probably audience must understand, beginning of talk, I give a message of my talk. So in previous work with Chunfang and PTCG from Jas, we derived a world-crossing formula of K-theoretic vortex partition function in three-dimensional energy to supersymmetric cases. So K-theoretic vortex partition function is index for Hausdorff. And this partition function contains a certain parameter for the level coming from the 3D level of the chancellor level in three-dimensional case. And if we choose a chancellor level 0, and this also contains a certain integer parameter, this is the number of chiral. And if we choose a number of chiral multiple, then our world crossing formula coincides with Kajihara transformation of hyperdimensionalities. And if we choose chancellor level appropriately, this level, this value is different from this one, then world crossing formula gives the relation between the theoretic functions of x and x tilde. Here, x and x tilde appear in the gauge theory as modular specific branch back here of two gauge theories. And these two gauges are called fiber-like here. And this relation of the K-theoretic eye function, more precisely its level structure, was first derived by Tom and Ben about 3 years ago for two class numbers. And we can consider a similar story in n equal 4 case. So n equal 4, carry n equal 4 and carry n equal 2, the type of supersymmetry. In this case, a modular space of Higgs branch back here is scalar, and the n equal 4 case, a modular space of Higgs branch back here is hyperdimensional. Then we can consider the same story about the way. In this case, K theoretic vortex partition function coincides with high y genus of Hausdorff invariant. And then a world crossing formula coincides with the Kajihara. And also, world crossing formula lead to a relation between K-theoretic eye function, tangent 1 of 2 class manias. Again, these tangent 1 of class manias appear as the modular space of Higgs branch back here, hyperdimensional pair. And in this case, we do not have a chancellor level, so cousin of Kajihara transformation directly related to the relation to K-theoretic. So these are my message of talk. Now I move to the content of my talk. First I explain passage three-dimensional n equal 2 supersymmetry. So three-dimensional n equal 2 supersymmetry case theory consists of two supermultiplets. Supermultiplet is a set of fields which are exchanged by supersymmetric transformation. And the n equal 2 case, there are two types of supermultiplet. One is called G vector multiplet. Here G is compact ring. And in particular, it contains a G gauge field or a mathematician called G connection and other field, but I don't explain the other field. And second multiplet is called chiral. In particular, it contains scalar field chi, phi, and this parameter is a modular space of Higgs branch. And this belongs to the representation of B. It is often convenient to introduce Kuiper diagram to specify this case theory. here each number N0, N1, N2, each number denotes a unitary. So, for example, N0 means the unit. And difference between circle and box the following. A circle, a number with circle denotes a gauge group. So, gauge group for this theory is UN1. And number with box denotes in physics language, it represents a flavor group. And in math, it corresponds to the flavor. Yes. And arrow denotes a representation of this hierarchy. So in this case, we have two arrows, and each arrow, for example, this arrow, from N2 to N1, denotes a home CN1 to N2. And there are two arrows, so in this case, representation is some of these two homes. Then we can write a Lagrangian, like a supersymmetric transformation term. And in the Lagrangian, in particular, it has a potential function. And zero locus of potential function is called moduli space of backyard. And the moduli space of backyard in this case is given by this equation. Here, theta is, xi is called the FI parameter, real parameter. And in my talk, I assume that this is positive. Then this equation is same as the universal, sum of universal bundle over the last one. Yes. And we consider two gauge theory. One is specified in the I already explained. And here, K1 denotes the transfer. And the other gauge theory is gauge group UN2 minus N1, which is doubled by this Weaver diagram. And these two theories are cyber-like duality. So duality, there is a duality between these two gauge theories. And in the next slide, I briefly explain what is duality. And in this slide, moduli space of Higgs branch backyard is universal quotient bundle over another class. And if level and number of two chiral matches such as this relation, in the dual side, we have additional simple chiral multiplet, plus or three minus. Here, singlet means that this chiral multiplet are trivially represented, belong to trivial representation of this unit. And duality, such as cyber-like duality, and mirror symmetry, which appear in several talks in this workshop, are roughly speaking, equivalence of two supersymmetric quantum fields. More precisely, two UV different descriptions from the same IR fit. One, so it's same as a universality. This is same as universality plus in the two dimensions. And if theory A and theory B are dual each other, then supersymmetric indices or partition functions or correlation functions of data predicted by supersymmetry are expected to agree with each other. So for example, this capital C some supersymmetric index of theory A defined on space-time M. They should agree. But even in physics, it's difficult to show this equality because this index is usually represented and defined by past integral, which is infinite dimensional integral, and also integral is very complicated functional of field. But if a supersymmetric localization formula exists, this is some method to evaluate this one. Then, path integral reduces the finite dimensional quantum integral. So, localization by the localization formula, we have a mathematically well-defined quantum integral expression for supersymmetric. Then, the problem to show this equality reduced to show the equality between two different quantum. sometimes people on the field of mathematics. And in my talk, I consider supersymmetric index of this case theory defined on space time S1 cross S2. And this Q denotes the omega background parameter along S2 dimension. And by using the supersymmetric localization formula, which was formulated by Benita Faroni, we apply the Benita Faroni formula to this case theory, then we obtain this quantized integral expression of index. Here, summation and integral come from the first integral. So this M corresponds, it comes from the first term number of gauge field of this U-gain-1. And the choice of a quanta is determined by a so-called Jeffrey-Kawan-Legge operation. I don't explain because it's difficult. That's complicated. But this choice of a quanta correlates with, important point is correlated with the sign of FI three-dimensional triangle. And in the positive FI parameter, we pick up the residue coming from the denominator of the second factor in the third one, this one. On the other hand, if you choose the negative hyperparameter, if theory is in negative hyperparameter, danger take at this one. And the integrand consists of FI term contribution, and z, small z, is a roughly speaking exponential. Exponential FI pattern in physics. And if we relate this index to quantum case theory, this corresponds to quantum parameter. And the second line comes from one loop determinant of vector matrix, and the third line comes from one loop determinant of two chiral matrix. And this x0 and x2 correspond to a mass parameter in physics associated with and these two parameters, x0 and x2, correspond to an equivalent parameter case. If we relate this index to so this index is a function of x0, x2, and small z, and also omega background parameter.
And is the first sum from A equal 1 to N1 is a typo?
This. Yes, thank you.
This is not necessary.
Yeah, not necessary. Okay. And I should give one comment. If we shrink the size of S2, then this index due to the partition, topological iteration partition function on S2, and which is called omega deformed S2. And then if we set Q is 1, then this dimension, this index reduces the ordinary A position. And after some massage of integral, we can realize the index to the pair of function xi. So you obtain the factor dimension of the index. And in the first line, quantum integral is divided. Yeah, and we can express evaluate the quantum integral and final expression in this expression Ix is given by this equation series expansion and each coefficient Ikx is given by this function. Here I write include the generic transform method. So there are many types of chance and measures, K1, K11, K2, K21, and K01. Here K1 is the ordinary chance and measure. Yeah. So this K1 is ordinary chance and measure. A1 is a gauge field. But in general, we can introduce another type of chance assignment term, other type. Yeah, for example, 1, 2, A denotes that. Trace of A1, weighted trace of like this. Here, A2 is a background image. UN2 is a flavor symmetric group. So we do not perform the passive integral over this edge field for UN2. So the index is a function of this edge field. And more precisely, the exponential of this A2 is a definition of S2. And so this is a generic form of the definition of IKX. And in my talk, I call this IKX as K vortex partition. So far, it's not a relation between IKX and vortex. It's not clear, but later we will show the precise relation. Then, after change of variable, then this generative function of IKX with zero chance time level, as I said in the beginning of my talk, coincide with multiple basic hypergeometric series of type A in the Kajihara's paper's notation is this. And if we choose another chance level, then this IX agrees with the K-theoretical function of the modular space. Yeah, in this case, modular space is given by this. And I give one comment. For n equals 0, n0 equals 0 case, so x is plus 1 in case, the relation between index, supersymmetric index, and I function was originally derived by work with Kazu. And we also showed that if Q is set to 1, then Wilson correlation function of supersymmetric is inserted along S1 direction, agree with the constant case. So in this sense, this Z corresponds to a constant parameter, and X2 corresponds to equivalent parameter of Grassmann. And similarly, we can do a parallel computation in cyber-like real size. So the gauge theory, gauge group is UN2 minus N1. The parallel computation again gives a similar type of factorization, and I named again, this IX tilde with zero chance level coincides with the multiple hypergeometric series of type A, but different. In the Kajihara's notation, IX tilde is appropriate after change of somebody. And if we choose a chance level appropriate, then IX tilde agrees with K-theoretic I function of modular space of this branch back of this UN2 minus N1. Which is universal quotient one or another question. Before I explain the implications of cyber-reality, I briefly explain the physical interpretation or physical exploration of the factorization in IX. In physics, factorization of this index into the pair of IX is explained by Higgs interpretation. This feature is originally developed by Benedict Lemonet in two dimensions and three dimensional case with Fujitsuka and we developed the Higgs branch operation. And after only 1 week later, 1 week after we have the paper, Benedict's paper appeared. And in the Higgs branch operation, path integral, we can show the path integral localized the modular space of vortex at North Pole. And south pole of S2. This S2 is the same as this S2. So we have a vortex equation and anti-vortex equation at the north and south pole of S2. vortex equation is given by this equation. And this have a distinct topological sectorized labeled by first channel 1. And later this K is identified with this K appearing the IKX. Then path integral over moduli space is should be identified with the mid-plane index for supersymmetric ground quantum mechanism. S1, S1 is this S1, with K vortex moduli. And in mass similar factorization is known. More precisely, rational version of the factorization. This factorization, rational version of the this factorization, agreeing with the sister organization formula for integral over the equation. And but in the mental case, the GE constant is and we study the relation between supersymmetric localization formula and the generalization of the given tals formula to know case is greater and also with both and Johnson and Cass segregation. So then a factor is an integration from side Cyber-gravity, as I said, implies the equality of supersymmetric index of two theories. So the index of theory UN1 theory, UN1 theory, should agree with supersymmetric index of UN2 minus N1. And the, from the factorization, as I said, is factorized the pair of function IX and decided factorized. The problem to show the equality of two indices is equivalent to show the relation for equality of xi and xt. And it turns out that to find the relation between ix and xt is equivalent to calculate or find the whole process formula of the index of supersymmetric quantum. Next, I explain vortex relation between super split index and vortex function and the whole process. So, vortex moduli space is given by partial differential equation. So, it's not easy to determine. But the brain construction of the disk K vortex moduli space by Hanalyton here, K corresponds. Then mid-ten index, we can show the mid-ten index agree with the mid-ten index for vortex moduli space agree with the mid-ten index of supersymmetric quantum mechanics denoted by this clipper diagram. Here again, each number denotes a unitary group. But the arrow, meaning of arrow is slightly different. In previous case, each arrow denotes a three-dimensional input chiral space. But in this case, this arrow denotes a one-dimensional input chiral. And one-dimensional input to a Superman space contains additional Superman space denoted by this dashed arrow, which is called Fermion. Roughly speaking, this is a bunch of Fermion and on which UN0 acts. And Higgs branch backyard, moduli space of Higgs branch backyard of this supersymmetric quantum mechanics is given by this, which is isomorphic to the right transform. So in physics, we scalar quotient here. Usually, mathematicians define the Hausdorff inequality by divided by GLK with the relation with certain stability. And this Hausdorff equality is positive. This is a one-dimensional hypervector. And this is different from the three-dimensional hypervector. In the positive hypervector region, this space is isomorphic to the K-vortex. In physics, this isomorphism between K-vortex and Hausdorff equality was first shown by Norris Kesakai and Hausdorff. Probably, I don't know much about the Udward で、again, we can evaluate a bit-endless associated with this one-dimensional cleaver by using a localization formula by quality. Then we have a following contour integral expression for the bit-endless. This one. And again, contour is specified by Jeffrey coverage, which correlates with the sign of one-dimensional cleaver. And associated with Weber group, three mass bar data. So 1 to n corresponds to the mass of this frame. And n1 plus 1 to n2 is the mass bar data for this frame group. And m tilde corresponds to the mass of the frame. And we have additional and in positive SI parameter region. So that this is a residual iteration. A pole denoted by red box contributes to the residual iteration. And we obtain this combinatorial expression. So this is a vortex analog of Nekrasov's iteration K is the normalization. In the Nekrasov case, summation is labeled by some triple, n-triple Young diagram, whose number of box, total number of box is k. In similar manner, in this case, we have a sum which corresponds to the Young diagram in single mode. So this is a partition. This is the same as the Young diagram in single mode. And we find that this combined Nekrasov-like formula is actually equal to IKX, which appears in the factorization with this identification. So actually this bit-end index or IKX creates the vortex modulator. And in the negative SI parameter region, all labeled by this blue box contributes the operation and we obtain and similar way, we can evaluate the, we can have a Nekrasov-like formula in the dual case of this side, K-vortex partition function of un2 minus n1 case. And by comparing the vortex partition function in positive hyperparameter of this case theory to the vortex partition function of un1 case theory in negative hyperparameter, we have agreement by change of sign, change of so to show the relation, to find the relation between a vortex partition function in two case theory is equivalent to find the relation between a vortex partition function un1 case theory in positive and negative hyperparameter. And in general, these two vortex partition function defined two regions are different. By the way, this theta corresponds to the stability function. So, wall-crossing formula of vortex partition function in UN1 case theory is same as the relation between vortex partition function in 3D cycle. And in order to show the calculate wall-crossing formula, so this part is the derivation of wall-crossing formula. We introduce curly ZK, which is defined by this contour integral. Here, integrand is defined by this, and this is same as integrand of K vortex partition function appeared in the previous slide. But the difference is the choice of contour. In the previous case, the contour is determined by Jeffrey coverage operation. But in this case, we choose a unit circle. And we assume exponential of omega background is inside the unit circle. And also mass parameter and mass parameter coming from this part. And times exponential omega parameter is also inside. On the other hand, this combination of mass and omega background parameter is outside of the unit circle. So this means that all correspond to the all contribute to the technical one is positive high parameter inside of this. And the Zeclical one, all contributing Zeclical residue operation in negative high parameter region, located inside, outside of the sum. So this is a condition, a minimum condition. Then if residue at the origin of this torus is zero, then this Cauley GK introduced by, defined by, yeah, is same as a vortex partition function of UN1 case. And also, if residue at infinity is zero, then this Cauley GK is same as vortex partition function UN1 in negative high parameter. And we can especially calculate this residue, this on-time integral, by taking the residue inside the circle or outside of the circle. And if we pick up the pole inside the unit circle, we obtain this expression. So Cauley GK consists of, this part is roughly speaking, residue coming from origin. And if this condition, this is Kronecker, is not satisfied, this N1 equal N0 is not saturated, then non-trivial residue does not exist at the origin, so all proceed. This factor is just one. Yes. And similarly, we evaluate the residue outside of the unit circle, we obtain this expression. And we multiply small zk, and sum over k, then we obtain this expression. Here, from this expression to obtain this expression, then we use a q-binomial. Then this infinite series becomes infinite. Here g plus minus infinite. So this is a whole crossing formula. These are chance limits. And if we include the chance limit level, relation is modified as this. So if this relation is saturated or this relation is saturated, whole crossing. And in three dimension, I will comment on the meaning of this parameter. Probably no one remember, but in the beginning of my talk, I said that if some relation is saturated, then additional singlet higher multiplying. So this, so in the level of supersymmetric index on this one process, twice of this factor appear in the UN 2 minus N1 case theory. And the square of this is exactly the same as the index contribution of two singlet chiral with plus minus. So this is the three-dimensional meaning of this small function. Then, by rewriting this relation, we obtain the Kajihara transform by the change of variable. Relation of the variable. So right-hand side is a notation by Kajihara, and left-hand side is my notation. By rewriting, then we obtain this Kajihara transform. So all crossing formula for indices or hands of equivalence is Kajihara. So this, in a sense, we gave some geometric interpretation of Kajihara, or a supersymmetric interpretation of Kajihara transformation. So this is the result, and I give some several remarks. So in our work with previous work with Okawa-san, we derived the national version of the whole crossing formula, mathematically rigorous way. Of course, this whole crossing formula, originally, this is not recognized as more. Originally, in physics, recognized as the relation between vortex partition function in cyberglass. We rigorously define, mathematically rigorously define this orthodoxy formula, and we pointed out this algorithm rationally, Kajihara transformation. And if we consider vortex partition function in a four-dimensional energy, ellipse one case, we obtain an elliptic list of partial function. But in this case, we will proceed. And we focus on three-dimensional energy, basically, but energy four version is quite partial. So in this case, we do not have any chance of then, case of the guy function. I didn't explain the detailed case of the guy function, but relation between the case of the guy function between two Higgs branch function is directly same as the all crossing formula for the vortex partition function in three dimensional energy. And this is equal to the energy of four cousin of the Euler transformation. And this is the explicit form of all crossing formula. Here, this T corresponds to the and in physics, this comes from the certain combination of the mass parameter. And in mass, this T corresponds to the sister action, acting on cotangent point. And here I consider S1 cross S2 index, but we can also consider other type of index. For example, we consider S1 cross S2 index. In work with Sugiyama-san, we define the supersymmetric index on the cross hemisphere and derive a supersymmetric localization. And if we apply this local, our localization formula to three-dimensional energy for GK theory with hypermanagement, and this space time have a boundary, so we have to specify the supersymmetric boundary motion at the boundary plan, and we choose the two common boundary. The index is written as this or this. So difference, we have two types of index. So this side we include the equal parameter, but three-dimensional equal parameter. This is three-dimensional equal parameter. But instead we can introduce a boundary elliptic genus. This is a boundary 0.2 multiplet to annihilate this part. Then boundary multiplet give a boundary elliptic genus. This one. So there are two types. Index, and after some massage of the contour, we obtain this expression. Here, this part is again case of the guy function of X branch material. And this part is in some sense Q deformation gamma plus. So this formula is Q deformation of the hemisphere partition function by polynomial order. In the hemisphere case, this object is give a solution of the Picard equation for Q difference, sorry, quantum differential equation. And similarly, if we choose the Higgs branch backyard property, this is a solution of some Q difference equation. And then, in the level of this index, all crossing formula leads to this. But I'm not sure, probably this index is related to function by other but I'm not sure this relation is mathematically interesting or not. So I summarize in my talk. I have derived a world crossing formula for vortex partition function for equivalent world crossing formula for indices of Hertzsprung equality with respect to stability condition. But this point is not new. Almost all the technique are developed by in my previous paper. And if we choose a chance of level, we bring to the Hajihara transformation. And other chance of level is the relation to the case of the guy function with the function. Excellent. It was originally studied by Tom Bennett's focus. And we can, as I said, we can consider an echo 4 version. And we can also consider the generalization to a Kleber, more complicated. For example, partial diagram of type A. And this is the Kleber diagram for three-dimensional energy to scale theory, which whose X branch backyard is vector bundle of partial diagram. And the modular space of vortex or BBS equation of this theory is given by this. And we can consider all crossing, structure, all crossing. Of this Kleber, L minus 1, this is all. Thank you.
Questions? With your method, can you also get an interpretation of a multivariate extension of Ramanujan's 1-1 summation? With your setup, with your methods, can you also interpret, combinatorially interpret, or in this way interpret Ramanujan's 1-1 summation and some multivariate extensions of that? It seems to be.
In some case, Ramanujan formula appear, but in the Ramanujan type of identity appear in different identity of the cyber-variety different super symmetry.
Because it seems like taking limits, it might be related. Other questions?
Can you do for the chain cell people? If there is only single vertex, that is something the block that can be blocked.
So in the chain fork bar, do you have a necular fork like of course, we can express a width index for chain cell quiver, but the other multiple quantile integral. But I'm not sure this quantile integral determined by Jeffrey Gauss. The population is expressly evaluated or not.
I mean, we just compute only the polar. It disappears again in diagrams.
Ah, yeah.
That is the computation more crossing is not so easy, so we can deal with some other integral, which is different from what you discussed. But the US method seems to be a little bit more powerful than
I see. Thank you for you.
More questions? If not, let's thank the speaker. Next talk will be in 15 minutes.
Yeah.